Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the 7th episode to create a static website using Bootstrap 4. In the previous episode, we worked on our works block, and today we'll be working on our themes block. So first of all, let's create a new section after the works block. Then let's add container flute div. I will call it themes block, and I will also add a class called theme block. Then for the title, I want to add a new div with a class called title holder, and then I will add my heading inside the s2 tag and subheading inside a new div with a class called subtitle. Now refresh the site again and you should see a title for our themes. Now let's add all of this content using Bootstrap grid. So just after this title holder, let's create a div with a class called row, and then inside row let's create a div with a class called col_sm and then tree. I'm using col_sm tree because this time the width of each column is 25%. Then for this image and this social media, I want to add them inside a div with a class called image. And for this content, I want to add a div with a class called content. So let's do it. So for image, let's create the image div, and then let's add the image using the image tag. And then for the social media, I want to create another div with a class called overlay, and then again another div with a class called socials. Then I want to use the on order list. There are three icons, so I'm gonna copy li two more times. And since the icons are the font awesome icon, I'm gonna use my developer tool to copy each of them. Otherwise you have to open your font awesome website and then you can grab these fonts. So after everything is done with the image div, for the content you can create another div with a class called content, and for the name you can use the s3 tag. For the designation, you can create a new span with a class called designation, and for the content you can simply use the p tag. So let's copy all of this content now. And once done, you can refresh the site. And you should see a content over there. Great. So if you are wondering how social media works when hover, then again it is because of our custom CSS, and the way of implementing CSS is exactly the same way as we did for our works block. Instead, this time we use the top value to 50% and the opacity to 0%. So now whenever the parent div is in hover state, the top value is set to 0 and then the opacity is set to 1, like this. Refresh the site again, since I have added all the content by pausing this video. And now it seems like it is looking exactly the same as in our design. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll work on the testimonial block. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel to get more tutorials in the future. Thank you.